WNDS Sports presents Candlepin Stars and Strikes, featuring the best Candlepin bowlers from all over New England, and now in our 14th season. Your hosts for Candlepin Stars and Strikes, Dick Letts and Mike Morris.
Hi again, everyone, and welcome to Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV from Lita Lanes in Nashville, New Hampshire. Dick Letts with Mike Morin. It's week three of our second ladder series of the season. And thus far, through the first 2 weeks, it's been the Bruno Defeo show.
It has. His newest competitor today will be Paul Willitts, who's been on TV 50 about a dozen times. Next week, though, the top of the ladder, Don Richmond. So there's lots of bowling to go till we get to the top.
Through the first 2 weeks of our series, Bruno Defeo has defeated Tom O'Brien and John Zappi. And now let's meet our bowlers for this afternoon's match. Our fourth seed and the winner of two matches in a row, Bruno Defeo from East Boston, Massachusetts.
And Bruno Defeo, Dick, is averaging right on his league average of 122 through his first couple of weeks. High single, 192, his high triple, 464. And Bruno is a bowler at Central Park Lanes in good old East Boston.
Bruno defeated Tom O'Brien 369 to 293. And last week he downed John Zappi 364 to 344. This week his opponent is Paul Willitts from Framingham.
Yes, he is, coming in with a 120 average. Paul's high single is 196, high triple at 467. Metro West and FICO's, the two bowling centers in Massachusetts where Paul calls home.
Let's get right to it. It's Bruno Defeo and Paul Willitts. Candlepin Stars and Strikes from Lita Lanes in Nashua. We're back with the match right after this on WNDS-TV. Ready to go as you take a look at the ladder, which leads to the championship match next week. Don Richmond, the top seed, waiting in the wings. He'll meet the winner of this match between Bruno Defeo and Paul Willitts. Defeo having beaten Tom O'Brien and John Zappi to get to this point. And it'll be Bruno Defeo first to bowl in this match this afternoon from Lita Lanes in Nashua. Starts out with a nine-pin drop.
And Bruno Defeo following a pattern that Rich Clark established on our last ladder, starting from the bottom and working his way up. Ooh, actually, Rich Clark made it to the championship match, but lost eventually to Gary Santora.
Bruno was tied with Tom O'Brien for the fourth seed. They tied at 6-18 in the roll-off. That one got away, and there'll be a three-pin fill in the spare. Roll-offs are ongoing, by the way, at Lita Lanes in Nashua. You can give them a call here anytime and find out more about when the next roll-offs could be taking place. And perhaps we may see you on one of our future telecasts on Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV. An eight box for Bruno Defeo, 21 through two. And now we get to look at Paul Willitts, 51 years old, school teacher at Holliston Middle School, teaches fifth grade math and science.
Also sits on the executive board of the World Candlepin Bowling Congress and the Senior Pro Tour. We'll talk a little bit about the Senior Tour later in the show today.
Auspicious start for Paul as he picks one.
It can only get better. I guess that's one way to look at it.
And it did right off the bat as he almost nailed the spare. Paul's been bowling 38 years.
Good try. Good
he starts out with an eight. Bowls at Metro West in Framingham and at, is it FICO's?
FICO's
in
Franklin.
Franklin.
Getting pretty good action.
Watch out.
Not so good hit. Everything ganging up there on the 10 pin should be, in fact, it seems to be leaning just a little bit.
It does, doesn't it? It's pitched just a little bit.
Maybe it's that scorpion bowl I had at the Kahala for lunch.
First mark of the match. If it wasn't the first one, it was the second one.
Yes. Oh, call me a cab.
All right, Bruno Defeo, both bowlers with a mark in their first two boxes. Defeo missing the head pin. If you have not seen either of the last couple of matches, we'll tell you a little bit about Bruno. He's 28 years old, married to Dory. He's a chemical operator for Raffi and Swanson in Wilmington. And attends as many Boston sports events as he can as a big follower of the Bruins. And one of his most memorable bowling matches on Channel 5 on the live show, he bowled women's tour player Janet Pock. Defeated her, but barely, and Janet was the only female ever to make that show, and Bruno escaped.
I remember watching it and talking to Janet afterwards, just being really nervous, as you can well imagine, the pressure of being the only woman ever in the 30 years of that show, all the big money that was at stake.
Station never made that show.
Surprisingly not. But I know it usually took about a 420 or so most years to make it.
Second spare of the match for Bruno Defeo in the fourth box. Now Paul Willitts, of course, Stacia Zernicki, who's one of the all-time great women bowlers from Webster, Massachusetts.
He passed away a couple of years ago.
When I was a kid growing up in Worcester being not far from Webster, and, mm-hmm. and certainly all of the notoriety that Stacia Zernicki had at the time, she was a legend. Eight box for Paul Willitts.
I check my notes, but I believe Stacia holds the record for most Pro Tour wins for a woman with 11.
Right through in a spread eagle.
Couple of bowlers at 10, and then it filters on down to one. But Stacia Zernicki, winner of 11 Pro Tour victories.
Boy, Paul almost pulled it off.
Tommy Olsen winning the most for the men at 17.
17 championships.
Is really stunning.
10 box for Paul Willitts, 41 through 4. I want to thank Ray Simoneau, proprietor at Lita Lane's, Sean Howard, the manager, Chris Beauvais is our official scorer. They always make things so nice, and they're accommodating to the fans who come in week after week for our taping sessions, once a month actually, for the weekly shows. They really go out of their way to make everyone comfortable. They've set up bleachers here now in the gallery area for people to find a place to sit and be comfortable. A large screen TV on the floor to our left as we look out to give people a look at the replays and a vantage point.
And they even give you a big bowl of M&Ms without the green ones, which you've stipulated in your contract.
Good try. 53 half for Bruno Defeo. On the head pin. Seemed as though he deserved better, didn't it?
It always does.
Now, this has interesting wood possibilities right here.
This is a very unusual leave. If you're a 10-pin bowler and you get this, you absolutely want out, run out of the building and leave. This is the most embarrassing combination you can leave as a 10-pin bowler.
This looks makeable if he hits the 5-pin.
Yes, sir. Good call.
Nice spare for Bruno. The wood was set up perfectly, and he took advantage of it. Hitting the 5-pin, of course, key. Now Paul Willitts missing the head pin. Willitts, a 626 in the roll-off, good for second place. Don Richmond, a 674 in the roll-off to really distance himself from the field.
Of course, we saw him a couple of weeks ago. So he returns now sitting atop the ladder.
Willitts and eight, a 49 half for Paul. Paul's married to Leslie for 29 years. And his children, all in their 20s, are Patrick, Laurie, Stacy, and Marie. And he became a grandfather in August. His granddaughter is Casey. Nice family.
Won't be long before he's probably got her in a pair of tiny bowling shoe booties and introduce her to the game. He's very, very active in various tournaments. He, like I said, sits on the board of the WCBC and the Senior Pro Tour. Bowling is his life, and he's very much liked
in bowling circles. I bowled with him for a while in the amateur Candlepin Tour, which is no more. It was kind of the level but below the Pro Tour for those of us not quite as gifted as the pros, but it was very competitive, and the money was as good or better than the Pro Tour because we had tournaments every week.
Nice shot that time by Paul as he avoided the wood that was out in front and picked up the spare. Very difficult shot that time for Paul Willitts, and he threaded the needle. Bruno Defeo on lane 34. Right in the pocket, leaving the 2-7 and no wood.
Call this a fit split if you do it right.
It fit right through that time.
It didn't touch a thing.
The ball fit perfectly.
There
That's
you go.
The way to do it. .81-7 now for Bruno with three marks in the first string. That's right in the pocket.
No doubt about that one.
Good pocket shot for Bruno. You'll see it again. Right in the 1-3 pocket. Now Paul Willitts tries to answer, and he just might. He puts 9 in his spare. And the 10 pin stands. Plays the wood, and he'll take the spare.
That's what it's there for, Paul. You don't need to be embarrassed.
Two marks in a row, a chance for some bonus money now for Paul Willitts. A spare here means $50 in his pocket.
Even though his ball breaks
Watch
from
out.
Right to left, it never quite came back far enough, leaving the four horsemen and a pin in the back.
On the head pin, got a shot at it. He'll take them all. Watch it again. He played it perfectly right between the 1 and the 2, and the wood slid across to take out the 9 pin.
That's $50 for that shot.
Bruno right in the pocket again. Two strikes in a row, and where are we in our triple strike jackpot? We are at $650. $650 for Bruno Defeo if he makes a strike right here. You watch. Spread eagle.
Yeah, the crowd was pulling for him. It's a shame. Another inch or two either way might have had it. Look at this.
Looking for bonus money. .134 first string for Bruno Defeo, and a thrill, a little bit of a rush as he tried for three strikes in a row and $650. Now Paul Willitts working on three marks in a row. Right on the head pin.
A nice fill, but a really tough spare with no wood to help him out at all.
The 4 and the 10. We'll take the 4 first.
I tell you, with the mark, he could be less than 10 pins behind if he can toss one here in the 10th frame.
111 for Paul through 9.
His average of 120 looks to be about where he'll end up.
Bruno has 5 marks in the first string. Paul on 4 so far. Missed the head pin, but didn't come out of it all that badly, has a makeable shot here. .139. On the head pin, he's got it. We're going to have a close match after one string. 121 plus a ball for Paul Willitts. Bruno finished with a 134. It'll be less than 10. It is an 8-pin, Phil, a 129 for Paul Willitts, a 5-pin lead for Bruno Defeo as we head to string number two. Good match unfolding in front of us and you as you watch Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV. Paul Willitts will be first to bowl in the second string. 134 for Bruno Defeo, 129 for Paul Willitts in the first string. A 5-pin margin for Bruno Defeo after one. And Paul Willitts starts the second string with a strike. Watch it again. Not much question about that one, was there?
None at all.
I mentioned earlier during the first string about roll-offs ongoing at Lita Lanes in Nashua. And what I neglected to do was to give you a phone number to call. And let me do that now, because as you're watching this show, you might want to call and inquire about when the next roll-off would be taking place. And you'll have an opportunity to compete, and maybe we'll see you on a future Candlepin Stars and Strikes show. Call Lita Lanes in Nashua at 603 is the area code, 889-4884. 889-4884 is the number for Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire. Ray Simoneaux, Sean Howard, or any of the people on staff here will be happy to help you out with the information and set you up for the next roll-off, and we'll look forward to seeing you on a future telecast. Ready to sign up, Michael?
No. Not into self-embarrassment that much. But our next taping, by the way, this being the 15th of November, is this Tuesday. Tuesday, the 17th of November.
Please come and join us. We start about 10 o'clock at Lita Lanes in Nashua, right off exit 7W of the Everett Turnpike if you're coming from south of Nashua, exit 8 if you're coming from Manchester. And we'd love to see you. Always plenty of room here at Lita Lanes, and as we mentioned, people who come really have a good time. Look at that shot. Whoa. By Bruno Defeo. Watch that one again.
Looked like the ball took out all the pins on the right side. Look at that.
The ball just about did it. Knocked the wood into it, but that was quite a shot.
Come on, mix them up.
Bruno looking for a break here. And let's see how the wood ends up. Well, again, the wood is there, Mike, in a situation where I think he can make this shot.
And it still hasn't stopped.
Well, that front wood's got to move to the... Well, I'm not... Now I don't like it that much. I liked it when the wood was a little... It was one turn to the left.
Do you want to cap it, or do you want to try to go right in between?
I'm going to cap it now and hope to kick that wood over and hope the ball takes the 7-pin.
I think going in but splitting them would do it. We're both wrong. That was tough and under any circumstances. Only the 7 going down, 8 and the 10 remaining.
And a 9 box for Bruno. He picks up 2 pins, and he leads by 7. We've seen some great shots already in this match.
Yeah, quite a few strikes.
Paul missed the head pin that time. And they continue to fall and scatter.
He'd kind of like to leave that wood in the middle of it all if he could, because that 5-pin will be the tough one to get out.
A 5-10 high triple, as you just saw in the graphic. Can't imagine that.
Well, he must have done that just recently.
It's not in our information, yeah.
Yeah, my records say 467. But perhaps he paid our graphics man a little extra
money
to doctor up the scores for him. Not that he couldn't do 5-10. It's a 170 average.
We'll check that one out, just for old time's sake.
I think Paul would be happy to claim that for a high triple, but I don't think that ever happened.
Get guys scrambling on the truck right now, trying to find out what happened.
I like to do that to him. Yeah.
Just missed it. Tough shot. He put it right where he had to, and the eight pin defied him.
Dissed him.
Yep.
The 90s version. Well, after a fast start for both bowlers, they're tapering off with eights and nines. So we head to our first break for this match.
Right through the middle. Spread eagle plus one. Gary Santora is already in the Tournament of Champions. He won our first ladder series.
Yeah, we saw Rich Clark for 4 weeks in a row, but falls just a little bit short in the all-important title match against Santora.
Nine box and a 44 through four as we take the break. A nine-pin lead. Check it, a seven-pin lead for Bruno Defeo. Four boxes into the second string. Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV. Paul Willitts steps to the line. He'll bowl first as we come back from the break. Box five, second string. Seven-pin lead in the match for Bruno Defeo. Willitts on the head pin, but leaves himself a little bit of a split. We straightened out the high triple situation. Paul Willitts' high triple is a 467. The 510 that you saw earlier attributed to Paul Willitts belongs to top seed Don Richmond. A 510 triple is a 170 average for three strings. 10 box for Willitts. Not that a 467 triple is anything to sneeze at.
It's about a 155, 56.
Bruno DeFeo's high triple is 464, which ain't too shabby either.
He's a young guy, got a lot of good years ahead of him at 28 years old. Fair amount of television experience. Paul Willitts visiting Channel 50, WNDS, a dozen times prior to today's show.
Watch out, could it come back and get it? Here it comes, not enough speed to get it. And this will be another 10 box for Paul Willitts, 64 through six. Make it 62 through six.
Little help maybe from the pin? No, rolling away. Side saddle triangle. The two, the five, and the eight.
The sleeper killed him that time. Couldn't touch it. Ten box for Bruno, 54 through five.
And nine marks, nine frames in a row without a mark between our two competitors today.
Again, just missing the head pin, leaving the four horsemen plus one. On the head pin, but the four pin still stands. And they match 10 boxes. Still a 7-pin lead in the match for Bruno Defeo. He led by 5 after the first string. He's added 2 to that. And Paul Willitts bowls in the 7th frame. Very soft hit, but the pins continue to fall.
And that's not a good break. Don't like to lose the head pin with this. That is an interesting combination.
And the wood, well, we'll have to see how he does it.
.379 remain.
Not a bad out. Box. Hope you've had a chance to watch our new nightly newscasts on WNDS News Now at 7 and 10, anchored by Alicia Tulanian, with meteorologist Al Caprillion, and yours truly on sports every night, Monday through Friday. News Now at 7 and at 10 on WNDS-TV. Hope you find it convenient. Hope you find it informative. And hope you enjoy watching at 7 and 10 o'clock every night. Well, he did only, the only thing he could do was to try to bust it down the middle, but the wood didn't help him. 10 bucks the hard way, and 81 through 8 for Paul Willitts, and now Bruno Defeo. Boy, both bowlers started the second string like a house of fire with marks, and they haven't marked since.
Which is how they ended the first string. But the fire is out. And nobody seems to want to take control of this match.
Bruno to the head pin. He's got pins dancing around, but not falling over.
And you got to like that, that deadwood lying right in that triangle.
That'll do it. That breaks a long, markless streak for both bowlers.
Yeah, about 12 boxes between the two of them without a mark.
Second mark in the string for Bruno Defeo. On the head pin that time, but didn't get a break, trying to bust up the split. And the wood angled in a way that could be advantageous for him.
If he can get enough of a deflection off the two pin, might be able to drive the ball right into that wood, into the 6-10. Had to hit it perfectly, though.
He did. Nice shot by Bruno Defeo to pick up his second spare in a row. You'll watch it again. Just as Mike Moran described it, it deflected off the front pin into the wood, into the 6 and the 10 pins in the right corner, and the spare was made. And Paul Willitts follows with the ball right on the head pin, punching through, taking 5.
Easy to analyze the game, how it should be played. Another story, though, getting out there and doing it the way these guys do.
Eight box for Paul. He's going to need a mark for 100 in the second string. It's always fascinating to me, as long as I've been watching bowling, watching the streaks, the highs and the lows, the peaks and the valleys that even the best bowlers encounter during matches of 3 strings, 5 strings, 10 strings. They'll bowl a 150 and then they'll come right back with a 94.
I think streakiness is just indigenous to sports in general, from gambling to team sports.
Paul lists as one of his career low lights, the lowest score ever bowled on the old Nesson show. He once bowled an 80 and then lost the match by 1 pin because of
imagine?
A lob. 7 on the on the spare, a 106. Second string for Paul Willitts. And I have to be honest with you, I don't remember the Nesson show. I don't think I watched it. I couldn't tell you when it was. I remember Channel 27 had a show a long time ago. Bob Foraker used to host it. From State Mutual, I think, is where they originated.
Many shows have come and gone over the years. Howard's now 15 years old. And to the best of my knowledge, the only regularly scheduled Candlepin bowling show on television anymore.
Unless they started one in California at that new lane out there.
Yeah. Wouldn't count on that.
Ten box for Bruno, 106 with a box to go. So he'll add to his lead. He had a five-pin lead after one string. He has 106 through nine. Willitts finished with a 106, so whatever he gets in this box adds on to his five-pin lead. So he's at 13 now with the eight-pin drop.
Kind of like the wood to just stay off to the left. Give him a nice clear shot at it.
Yeah, the wood continues to move. Well, Bruno's waiting. Certainly can understand his wanting to know where the wood's going to be when the ball gets there. He's trying to time it so the wood's out of the way. Here's the shot, and he picked it. A 115 second string for Bruno Defeo, a 14-pin lead in the match as we head to the third and final string with Bruno Defeo leading Paul Willitts on Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV. Bruno Defeo will be first to bowl in the third string. And he takes a 14-pin lead with him into the final string of this match with Paul Willitts. Right on the head pin. Will it go? Yes, it will. Bruno wasn't sure it was going as he was staring down in disbelief. The 5-pin. Will it? Won't it? Will it? Won't it? You see Bruno's arms come into the picture. Finally, it goes. Bruno looking for two in a row. He had two in a row in the first string and had a shot at the triple strike jackpot of $650. Now he's looking for two marks in a row. Four pieces of wood on the deck with the 8 and the 10 pin still standing. Not anymore. So Bruno starts with a couple of marks in the third string.
Boy, instant pressure on Paul Willitts, already trailing this match by 14. Finds himself even further behind now.
He needs to make marks. There he goes. A little bit of a delayed reaction on that one for Paul.
They all just collapsed.
Here they go, and there. It doesn't look it at this point, does it? And there they go.
Nice break.
Looking for two in a row on the head pin. Well, maybe we'll give away some bonus money in this third string. That would be nice.
Ray Simino's got the checkbook out, ready to put those names on the checks.
Looking for the spare. Two marks in a row for Paul Willitts. As under pressure, he responds to the two marks put up on the board by Bruno Defeo.
And our runner-up today takes home a check for $250. The winner goes on to meet Don Richmond, our top seed, next Sunday.
Looking for bonus money. They're surrounding the 10-pin, but the 10-pin still stands.
We're into one of those streaks you talked about last game, Dick. Well, now we're getting a lot of marks all is in a run. Seems like Bruno's putting a little something extra on the ball. It's getting that extra pin action.
Is it a foreign substance or anything like that? Is that what you're talking about?
We'll have him checked for that after the game, yeah. He's got some of that Mark McGuire juice in his bag, I've noticed.
Just missed it. This is a game of inches, and that one just missed. A $50 miss for Bruno.
That's too bad. Kind of takes the wind out of his sails.
But opens the door for Paul Willitts at the same time. Again, missing the head pin, but a 7-pin fall and a possible spare here. Tough shot. He got the head pin, but cut it a little bit too thin. Now two open frames. Paul Willitts will have an opportunity to move a little closer.
Yeah, this is his opportunity. Got to seize the moment right now.
The only bonus money we've given away in the match thus far, Paul Willitts had 3 marks in a row in the first string. This time he punches through, puts 3 in his spare.
Look at this.
Look at this. Watch out.
Last couple weeks, we've come very close to making that combination on the spread eagle. Several times, 5 of the 6 pins going down. Only the 10 remain, so it'll be a good out for a crummy first ball.
10 box. While they both marked in the first two frames, DeFeo still picked up 6 pins because he filled his second spare with 9 and Willitts filled his spare with 3. On the Brooklyn side and a solid 5-pin. And the mark for Paul Willitts, his third mark in 4 frames as we go to the break. Paul Willitts tries to come from behind to get back in the match with Bruno DeFeo as Candlepin Stars and Strikes continues from Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire on WNDS-TV. Bruno DeFeo gets ready to bowl in the 5th box of the 3rd string. He has a 19-pin lead in the match, but Paul Willitts will have a ball when he steps back up, working on a spare. Bruno in the pocket, another solid 5-pin. Our WNDS-TV crew working here at Lita Lanes, making it all possible for you to watch Candlepin Stars and Strikes each and every week, Sundays at noon, and other times on replay during the course of the week. There's the spare for Bruno DeFeo. Our director is Larry Taylor. Our audio is being handled by Kevin LaFond. The tape machine's manned by Dave McCarthy. Computer graphics, Dave Cates. On video is Paul Hunter. The camera crew, Bob Dold, Gary Van Nortwick, and Shane Windstorm. Now trying to fill the spare, Bruno DeFeo with 8, which is not a bad fall considering he missed the head pin.
And a very makeable spare to keep the heat on Paul Willitts.
There it is. 2 marks in a row now for Bruno, his 4th mark of the string. And he'll be looking at bonus money when he comes back up to the line. Now Paul Willitts working on a spare. Works on lane 34. Right on the head pin. Needs a break, can't get it. 8 pins, the fill, but a split and a tough one.
Paul is on the executive board of the Senior Professionals Candlepin Bowling Association, which continues to grow as many of the big star bowlers of years ago now are aging baby boomers. I guess that would be the politically correct way to put it. 50 years of age or older for men, 45 or older for women, and you can join the Senior Pro Tour. Paul Willitts can tell you how. I'll give you a phone number to call if you have an interest in it. Out on the Cape at Edgartown, it's 508-627-4883. That's 508-627-4883. And on the 21st and 22nd of November, the Senior Pro Tour will be at Vacation Land Bowl in Saco, Maine.
That time, Paul missed the head pin. Was fortunate to come out of it with a 6-pin drop. He's got a very difficult spare to make right here. He's on the head pin. There he goes. That's a tough shot for Paul Willitts, and a nice spare for him in the sixth box. Heading down the home stretch, it's about a 10-pin lead for Bruno Defeo.
Look at this.
They continue to fall.
That's the break that Paul Willitts didn't get two boxes ago with a similar type leave.
It was about a 10-pin lead in this string. He came in with a 14-pin lead, so his lead is roughly around 25 pins plus, depending on what Paul will do on his ball in the spare. And he missed the spare, so that'll be a 9-box for Bruno Defeo. Follows that up with, that pin got hit a couple of times, didn't fall. Sometimes it seems as though they're nailed into the ground.
And that gutter ball I just threw cost him 10 pins.
And there's a spare. It also cost him $50.
That's true. Actually 70, because it would have been four marks in a row. So a nice break for Paul Willitts, who's going to have to stay with him. And then some, as we're down to the last five boxes.
He missed a single pin spare earlier too in the third frame. Now Paul Willitts tries to make a run.
Well, he's getting some really nice mixing action today. He's got to be very pleased about that. Doesn't throw an overpowering ball, but he's got some good revolutions on it that keeps the pins spinning.
And a spare for Paul Willitts. Two marks in a row for Paul, a chance for some bonus money here.
Take the lead in this game with an 8-fill and a mark.
With two of the three open frames that Bruno Defeo has in this string were off 9-pin drops on the first ball that he failed to convert.
He could have put this match away by now, but he's let Paul Willitts hang in there with him.
Oh, tough spare.
Oh,
yes!
Yes!
A $50 spare for Paul Willitts, converting the split. Watch it again. Perfectly shot by Paul Willitts. You just don't do it any better than that. That's three marks in a row for Willitts. And he's trying to make a horse race out of this.
Box to box, we're tied in this match. Yeah, only a 4-fill.
The head pin still stands. Ten box for Bruno, 128 through nine.
Well, this will be Bruno's best showing so far, but don't know if it'll be enough yet to win, as Paul Willitts has his 9th and 10th frames to go.
Well, he'll certainly have the lead. And he threw it right in the pocket, and look what he ends up with.
He's going to wait and analyze this one, make sure the wood stops.
He's going to need a ricochet off of that. It's a possibility here.
Absolutely.
Michael. Nope.
Everything went to the left. Didn't get the deflection over to the 10 pin. 138 at best.
He is at 137, and it'll be a 138. And 387 triple for Bruno Defeo. 38 pins is what Paul Willitts needs in the last couple of frames. He grabs the head pin. Chance for some more bonus money. A That's another $20 in bonus money for Paul Willitts. All right, mathematician, where are we here?
Well, a 19-pin lead still for Bruno Defeo. Needs a 153 game to win.
He's in the pocket.
Look at this. He needs a mark. He needs to make the shot. Or he'll fall just short.
It's a makeable shot, obviously. There it is. He's on it. 151.
Well, he needs a couple of
pins
yet. Three pins. And an unbelievable win.
Two pins.
He needed a 153 game. So he needs two pins to win. One pin to tie. Keep it on the lane and don't foul. There it is.
A come from behind win for Paul Willitts over Bruno Defeo, 159, and a triple of 394. Willitts advances to the championship match next week against Don Richmond. We'll come back to meet our boulders in a moment on Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS TV. Paul Willitts defeats Bruno Defeo, 394 to 387, a come-from-behind win for Willitts and for Bruno Defeo. First, the paperwork will give you $250 as a consolation prize, and think about what might have been as you look back on this match, a couple of opportunities that you were not able to take advantage of that kind of come back to haunt you.
Yeah, I missed a couple, hit a couple, should have went, but what are you going to do? You take it in stride.
It's the nature of the game. This is your best triple of the three matches that you've had so far, and this is the one you lose.
Right. That's unfortunate. He was just a little bit better today, that's all.
Well, it was a great match. Great to see you, Bruno. Thank you very much. Congratulations to you. Hope to see you again down the road. Bruno Defeo from East Boston, our runner-up here this afternoon, and now Paul Willitts. We'll ask Paul to roll a ball on lane 33, and we'll try to match him up with a contest winner in our bonus ball contest. And we'll pull a postcard out of the bin, and go ahead, Paul, roll it right down there, and we'll see if we can match you up with a contest winner, depending on how many balls you do. Go right ahead. Roll it right down on lane 33, Paul Willitts, and Mike Morin will draw a postcard out. 7-8. It looks like an 8. Let's see if you can pull an 8 out of the basket there, Michael.
Do my
How
best.
Did you do? Let's see if I can find a number here. Son of a gun, you did it. Kay O'Mara,
right, we got
from Saugus, Massachusetts. She said 8, and she wins the jackpot, which is what?
$60.
Yep. $60 right. In the jackpot for Kay O'Mara of Saugus, Massachusetts. Congratulations,
Kay. Some free strings of bowling
Kay.
Here.
And now let's give some bowling away from Lita Lanes in Nashua, New Hampshire, to Marcel Halley of Manchester, New Hampshire. Marcel wins 10 free strings of bowling at Lita Lanes. And let's bring up the winner, Paul Willitts. Paul, come on up and join us. And a big round of applause for Paul Willitts, ladies and gentlemen. Paul, congratulations. This is one of those matches where you had him all the way, right?
That was a close one, boy. But, it's the type of game you got to stay with them, and those nines and tens add up at the end.
We were talking during the course of the match how it's such a hard game to figure out. You went in the second string a long period of time without marks, and then in the third string, bang, you're on target again. How do you explain it?
You don't explain it. I mean, if I could explain it, I'd be winning every time. But that's the nature of the game, I guess. Everybody has their good days. Everybody has their bad days. Today was my good day.
Well, congratulations to you. We'll look forward to seeing you in the championship match next week against Don Richmond. Congratulations. Paul Willitts, ladies and gentlemen, our winner here this afternoon. And that sets up a championship match next week against the top seed, Don Richmond.
Paul Willitts had some really good breaks today. He was remarkably consistent, but he'll be severely tested next week with a bowler you saw about a month ago, Don Richmond, sitting atop next week's championship ladder position.
Makes for a great match. We hope to see you then, as we look for another participant to join Gary Santora in our Tournament of Champions at the end of the season. It'll be Willitts and Richmond next week at Lita Lanes. For Mike Morin and our entire WNDS-TV crew, I'm Dick Lutz. Thanks for watching Candlepin Stars and Strikes on WNDS-TV. We'll see you next time.